At the height of the drought, scenes of thousands of dead fish floating in the Darling River told a story of heartbreak and environmental tragedy. But now, after a summer of rain, water is flowing into the Menindee Lakes for the first time in 5 years.
With a crank and a smile, the Water Minister and locals open the floodgates.
Keep going, faster!
And in the far west of New South Wales, the Menindee Lakes are getting a drink. Dry land soon to be lake bed.
It's just a very positive, happy day. One that's, in some respects, 5 years overdue. But it is very, very important.
It was just over 2 years ago when more than 1 million dead fish exposed the plight of the lake system. The water stopped flowing at the height of a crippling drought, bringing accusations of mismanagement. Heavy rain in southern Queensland and inland New South Wales is now sending water down the Barwon-Darling River through thirsty outback towns.
You know, there's a lot out there that needs to be protected.
A lot of your community.
Have fresh water back into the community.
A lot of this, yes.
Let's hope that they just don't let it go when they need it.
Graham McCrabb has fought for the Menindee Lakes. He says while the news is good today, if there's no change in how the water is managed, next time a drought hits, they'll be back in the same boat.
Gives you a short-term reprieve. You've got a bit more water here, but the rules still have a long way to go. It'd be horrific to go back through that fish kill process again. State governments running water when it crosses over so many borders, it's just not working.
The New South Wales government says between now and June, 850 gigalitres will flow through these gates and into the Menindee system. Lizzie Pearl, 9 News.